The ugly truth is this: healthcare is not treated as a human right in the United States of America. This fact is outrageous, and it is far past time that we change it.
I believe there are few issues more significant, few issues more impactful to the lives of everyday Americans than the ever-increasing cost of healthcare and the lack of access to vital treatment.
In 2018, 8.5% of Americans did not have access to healthcare.
When American citizens don't have healthcare, how can it impact not only individuals, but entire communities?
The future president and Congress have a responsibility to take care of the American people, which means amending our fractured healthcare system that currently causes countless individuals to have inadequate access to the care they need and deserve.
Think about how our healthcare system evolved. Here in the United States, we actually developed an employer-based approach to healthcare that happened during World War II. So the way businesses attracted people to work in their factories during World War II was to provide them healthcare benefits. And then after the war, essentially that became the norm.
49% of Americans get their health insurance from their job. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, about 14.7% of Americans lost both their jobs and their health insurance.
This system that we've had since World War II of connecting our health insurance or our health security to our job is not the optimal system that you would design if you were designing one for the 21st century.
When you talk about why people can be employed and not have healthcare, well, that's because the employers have decided that for their employees, that's not something that they need to provide, and because there's no requirement for them to provide it.
You know, employers and workers together have to pay for health benefits for most people. And, you know, the more money that they're spending on healthcare, that's the less money that they can pay people in wages. It's less money that they could invest in other parts of their company.
Governments played a major role in providing people access to healthcare through programs like Medicare for seniors and Medicaid for people who are low income.
There are a few initiatives, including Medicare for All and the public option, which have been proposed to increase healthcare accessibility in the U.S.
Well, Medicare for All would basically, in theory, take the Medicare program that's very popular, that serves about 60 million seniors and people with disabilities, and expand it to everyone.
Joe Biden's primary campaign promise regarding healthcare was to push for the public option.
A public option would create a government-type program like Medicare, like Medicaid, and make it more available. Right now, you have to meet certain qualifications to get into any of the government-provided health programs. A public option would make it much easier for people to get into government-paid healthcare.
The United States spends more money on healthcare than any other rich country in the world. And for that, we don't get particularly good results or outcomes from it. And it doesn't pay for value.
The Affordable Care Act, passed in 2010, was one of the most impactful changes in the U.S. healthcare system.
Now, the Affordable Care Act expanded Medicaid coverage, the income limits for that, up to a certain limit. So we still have 14 out of our 50 states that have not expanded Medicaid. So if you live in California, people can get Medicaid up to what's known as 134% of the federal poverty level.
And here in California, since we embraced the ACA, we've reduced our uninsured by over half.
When Trump was president, he was trying to get rid of the Affordable Care Act. Now that Biden is president, Affordable Care Act will definitely stay, and most likely it'll be stronger.
But what's really gaining traction among the Democratic electorate, I think, is this idea that the Affordable Care Act was a really good starting point. And how do we build on that?
When someone has poor health, it not only affects themselves, and it doesn't even just affect their immediate family, it affects the whole community.
We have to start to realize that the health of one person is directly related to the health of each other. Everybody is harmed when somebody doesn't have health care.
Certainly access to health care is very important. It's only one component in health, right? So that's why we need to think about what we call health in all policies. So how we build our roads and where we put our parks and the type of housing we have all impacts health. So we can't just depend on healthcare to take care of all of that. But certainly healthcare has a profound impact on our lives.
With the election that happened, the whole landscape of healthcare is gonna change. You know, Biden says that he's gonna make all these changes, but the president can't make changes by himself.
The, you know, employment-based insurance coverage in this country only covers a relatively small percentage of the population, and an even smaller percentage, is it adequate?
The crux of having healthcare trickles down into almost every aspect of one's life.
And people should never have to make the unthinkable decision about whether to purchase their medications or to put food on the table or gas in their car.
This is an absurd way to run a healthcare system.
People are paying too much. Most people have insurance, but a substantial number of people still do not. A lot of the people who do have insurance literally can't afford to use their insurance. Everybody agrees that we need to fix what's broken.
That is why I am here today, urging you to build a more rational, fair, efficient, and effective system.